RESTful web services provide a lightweight and secure way to move data between devices using hypertext transfer protocols. REST, or Representational State Transfer, is supported by both the SNAP PAC and groov APIs to make data store, variable, and I/O tags available over either HTTP or HTTPS. In this workshop, I'll go over to how to make both groov and SNAP RESTful requests, view the results, make API requests from Python in the command line, and finally, I'll use the software app named Postman to interact with the APIs. I will be posting data to and getting data from both this Groovbox and this SNAP PAC Learning Center. The Groovbox is an industrially hardened edge computing appliance preloaded with software for creating and serving mobile and web-based graphical user interfaces. The Groovbox also includes Node-RED, an IoT application development environment. The Learning Center is basically a SNAP PAC system with a controller, several I/O modules, and a rack. We use it for training here at Opto 22. This front panel simulates some typical I/O signals like a meter, temperature sensor, potentiometer, LEDs, switches, and a buzzer. The controller is running a convenience store strategy that's loaded into its memory. Since I already have a list set up, I'll go into the browser and get started building the request URLs. First, the Groovbox. I'll bring open the REST API interface by going to my Groovbox's help and selecting Groov Public API. Even if you don't have access to a Groovbox, this reference page will be available in a link below. Here, you can also find the Opto 22 developer site with links to the Groov REST API and a whole bunch of other things. Here, I'll bring this open and I can see how to build my URL. The most basic call is pretty straightforward. All I need is https://my/api/v1/datastore, and then whatever I'm getting, in this case just a list of tags, and I follow that with my API key. I'll enter this URL into my browser and make sure to authenticate it using an API key and the field ?API_key=, and then supply my API key. When I hit enter, I can see the full list of tags from all the devices and all the data stores on my Groovbox. Right now, I'm viewing the JSON object through a browser extension so that the sections are collapsible and the text is colored. But this isn't the only information that's available to me. Using this reference page, I can see that I'm able to request information about the Groov instance that I'm running, the users whose API key I'm using, as well as reading and writing specific tags. In order to do that, I'll need a specific tag's ID number, so I can pick one from this list I just got, like tag number 84, sunrise. All I have to do to read this tag is put in the URL /read/the ID number. And there we go. I can see that the sun rises at 6:32 a.m. Now, the SNAP PAC controller. On the developer site, there's another link for the SNAP PAC API. On this page, there's a link to another REST API reference page that you can use to help build your URLs. Here, you can see the exact URL extensions you'll need to access everything on the PAC, from analog and digital I/O to strategy variables and even details on the device and firmware. Using this reference page, you can easily set up the exact URL you'll need for your application. You can set up your SNAP PAC controller for either HTTP or HTTPS. Mine is set up for HTTP. Here in my browser, I'll build a URL to go to my controller's IP, and then this part of the API's URL is very similar to the Groov's API. I use API/v1/device/strategy to get into my device. Then I have to specify whether I'm reading an I/O point, a variable, or a table. Here I'm getting the I/O from the analog inputs called fuel level. Reading analog inputs and outputs, I also have to specify that I'm getting the engineering units of this point. When I hit enter, I'll be asked for basic authentication credentials, which I already configured when I enabled the RESTful interface. You can manage these at your controller's IP/admin/keys. Once I enter my ID and value into the request pop-up and log in, I'll see a JSON object holding the potentiometer's current value. If I were to change the fuel level and then make this request again, I get a different value, so we know it's live. Now that I've created and tested some Snap and Groov URLs in the browser, I'll take them over to a Python script and show you how you can programmatically make RESTful requests, both GET and POST, for both the Snap PAC and Groov APIs using the requests library. First, you'll want to make sure you import requests. If the library isn't showing up, you'll need to use pip to install it. From here, I'll read the IO's digital output points without a specific variable in mind, and I don't need engineering units since I'm reading digital, not analog points. I hand in my host IP's address, build a URL, and hand that to the requests library. It's important that when making the GET request that you include the field auth equals and hand in the ID, value key set to the requests function as a parameter. Otherwise, you won't be authorized. Once I've made the request, I can get the results back using g.content to get the content and then .decode to turn the bytes into a string. When I run this script, I'll see that the list includes an alarm that is currently turned off, a freezer door that is closed, and inside and outside lights that are both turned on. To give you an example of a POST request, I'll turn the inside light off. So I'll start by setting my variable string to hold inside light. Since I'm changing the state of this variable, I will need to append /state at the very end. Since I'll be making a POST request, I need to change my function from GET to POST, and I'll also need to hand in some data. That data will be a JSON object, so I frame it with curly braces. What I'm putting in is the value, and I'll be handing it the Boolean value false. To make sure that this is a Boolean value and not a string, I make sure not to put quotes around false, but since the value is a string, I'll need to use the /quote escape character to insert the quotes in the middle of the string. Once I'm handing this data and my authorization credentials in, I can save my script, execute it, and see the inside light turn off. All it would take to read and or write from any other I/O point or variable in the PAC controller is a couple of minor changes in the URL I just built. With the same requests library, I can use Python to access my data store tags in my Groov box. Since they're such different devices, I'll start a fresh request and comment out the Snap PAC code. I'll scroll down and uncomment some code I prepared earlier. This is going to check my Groov box for the tag number 127. It holds a list of earthquakes in my Groov box. I'm going to be reading this tag, so I set that as the command and hand in an extra parameter with count equal to 5 to make sure I get all 5 values from the table. Here, I could also set an index parameter to set where I start the count. The other parameter I'm handing in is my API key. Note that the Snap PAC used basic authentication to get in, but the Groov box is using query parameters, so I don't need to hand in my authentication to the function, I just need to append it at the end of the URL using API key equal to my API key string. These query parameters attached to the URL need to be separated by ampersands, which is why that character is there. But it also means that I don't need to hand them into the request function, I just need to set verify equal to false, since the Groov box only allows requests to be made over HTTPS. I'll save this script and run it, and I can see all my earthquakes appear in the window below. Now I'm going to overwrite one value in the table, and I can only do one at a time using the API. If I wanted to write to a single tag rather than an item in a table, it would be exactly like this, only I wouldn't set the index tag. Since I am writing to a table, I'll set my index equal to 3. So I write to the third item in the table. Since I'm using the Groov API, I won't be handing in the value to the request function. It is also a query parameter, so I attach it with the ampersand value equal to, and I'm going to hand in the string hello from Python. Note that I used the plus symbol between words in the value string, since this is a URL and the space character would not be valid. Here I can rebuild the URL the same way, and all I need to do is change my requests.get function to requests.post, keep my URL and verification on false, and I'm good to go. Now I can save the script and execute it. It went through successfully, so now I'll go over to Groov, bring open Groov View, and I can see that the fourth earthquake, at index 3 since it's 0-based, is now holding the string hello from Python. So there we go, that's reading and writing SNAP PAC controller tags and Groov data store tags using the requests library to make RESTful API calls programmatically. So now I'll take these requests to the command line. I'll bring open this prompt, and the command I use is curl. First, I'm going to hit the Groov API, so I have to disable SSL certificates with minus K. Then I can use the same URL as I did in Python. I make this request, and there is the list of 5 earthquakes. And to make a post, I can use curl minus K minus capital X followed by the keyword post to set my request type. From there, I can use the same URL as I did in Python, and I'll just make a few changes. I'll go through and change the read command to write. Select index 4 to get the last item in the table. And hand in the value hello from command. Now I'll make this command. Go back to Groov View, and I can see my change string appear here. The SNAP PAC request is done similarly, but rather than using minus K to allow an unknown certificate like with the Groov box, you use minus minus user and your key value pair to authenticate. Then the URL will be the same as Python and the browser. Make sure that the entire URL is exact, because a single typo will cause the request to fail. Then, when posting to a PAC controller, use minus x post to set the request type, minus minus user for basic authentication, and then minus d followed by the JSON value string to set the data that you want posted. I'll use this instruction to turn the inside light back on from the command line. It's that easy to use SNAP PAC and Groov APIs with curl. Anywhere that you have curl access, you can get your Opto data. Finally, another way you may want to use these APIs is from Postman. Postman is a powerful developer app designed to test, develop, and document APIs. It makes building simple and complex HTTP requests fast and straightforward. Now that you've had some exposure to the APIs, Postman will be really easy. Recall that the PAC uses basic authentication, so hand in your ID value pair. Then all you have to do is put in the request URL and hit send. Here I am showing a list of all the int32s on my device. You can see that fuel low limit is set to 1000. I'd like to increase that to 1500. To do that, I will switch from get to post and hand in a body parameter that holds the raw text JSON value 1500. I also need to specify that I am changing the fuel low limit. Now I can hit send, make the get request again, and I'll see that the value has changed. To access the Groov API, I have SSL certificates disabled, so I can enter the URL right away. Instead of handing in basic authentication, I'll disable that and hand in my parameters using this feature of Postman. Here I can set my query parameters like count of 5 and my API key. And you can see that they're appended directly to the URL. Now when I click send on my GET request, you can see the table appear below, including the hello from Python and hello command changes I made earlier. To make a post, I'll set the index parameter to 2, disable the count parameter, and also hand in a value holding hello from Postman. Now all I have to do is change the request type from GET to POST and change the URL from READ to WRITE. Now when I hit SEND, I get confirmation, and if I go over to Groov, I can see it updated in the list here as well. Now with those URLs in and working, it's possible to make use of all the features of Postman, including scripts, collections, and monitors. You can find out more at getpostman.com. So it's that easy to use the SNAP PAC and Groov REST APIs with everything from Postman to Python and even the browser or command line. To learn more about these systems, check out workshops.opto22.com and developer.opto22.com. For more examples and assistance, check out our user forums at forums.opto22.com. Thanks for watching.